Let's take a look at the Kimura through the eyes of a white belt and how that changes as you work towards your black belt. The white belt begins by recognizing the position itself. The Kimura is a shoulder lock, often first taught from the guard, and it begins by uncrossing my ankles, sitting up, and grabbing my wrist. Then, I move my hips to the side, lock my legs, and rotate for the submission. Some people like to grip with their thumb. Others prefer no thumbs. There are many ways to do this technique. Now that you know the Kimura, you have to know what's next. Your opponent will want to posture up and pull their arm free, so expect it. Flow with it. Add to it. This is a Jiu in Jiu Jitsu. Then backstep and end with the Kimura that you started out with. This single technique will teach you about timing, sensitivity, and how to adapt until you achieve your goal. To understand the Kimura, you have to know its neighbors, like the straight arm lock and the Americana, or Udegarami in Japanese. Then, it's back to Jujigatame and Gyaku Udegarami, or reverse arm entanglement, also known as the Kimura. If my opponent gets a Kimura from half guard, I'll block it with my thigh, push off of his hip, and finish with my own Kimura. From full guard, I can reverse into an arm lock. The moment he uncrosses his ankles to sit up for my arm, I point my fingers backwards, transfer weight into my hands, and rotate to the other side of his body. But you have to be quick, ready for action, and with a high level of awareness. Now from half guard, as I drive my knee down, it's natural for your opponent to reach out their hand to stop the knee. This gives me the wrist control for several arm locks, including the Kimura. Now, the Kimura is the starting point, and the finish is a straight arm lock. The darker your belt color becomes, the better you get at setting people up. Take the Kimura during the guard pass, and lift the hand as it comes off of your leg. You're not forcing his hand, you're guiding him. It's a moment during a transition, but that's where the magic is. Then take advantage of his position by bridging, sweeping him over, and finishing with the Kimura. Apply pressure to his shoulder by angling your body, which limits his range of motion. If he blocks his Kimura by cupping his thigh, spin under, sweep him, and take the top position. Finally, end with a Kimura of your own. Beginners are often taught to pull up and turn to finish the Kimura. Experts might shorten that and add in a spiral. Explore details like rolling your wrists up, creating a twist in the arm, or even adding on a wrist lock. Pull away from his fingers to break his grip, and do it quickly, with confidence. Now, if you're unable to break the grip, then look at what's nearby and available. Make him want to let go to defend another area, or move on to attack the neck. Pull him back, and agree with his decision to not let go. Perhaps even assist him with a bind as you move on to the next target. The epiphanies will continue. You'll find the Kimura as they defend the triangle. It can be a full Kimura with the wrist, pulling with your arms and extending with your legs. Or it could be achieved by rolling his elbow forward. Improvised mechanics are a signature of the advanced game. And of course, the Kimura can also lead to the triangle or arm lock. They're all equal to the black belt, taken without attachment. Fixation can backfire. Globalize your game. Trade submissions freely. That's when you begin to see new ways to use techniques. Creatively. Experiment with rolling into the Kimura and use it as an anchor for the arm lock. Unexpected entries are often unguarded and therefore easier to access. Use this idea to spin to a back triangle and finish with the Kimura. Different angle, different position, same Kimura. Assemble what you can while in the air, and apply when your positioning is secure. Now, you're really starting to understand that a black belt, the Kimura is everywhere. Off of a waist grip to the Kimura. From a headlock escape to the Kimura. In a wrestling sit-out to the Kimura. Or as a Kimura counter to the wrestling sit-out. The Kimura is now your tool, your technique, to use as you see fit, sometimes as a submission, but not always, not necessarily. You must know all things like the Kimura, how to do it, how to tighten it, how to lay a trap, how to follow the resistance. The Kimura is part of a system, a program, a game, which a white belt is learning and the black belt has already mastered. The more deeply you study the Kimura, the more creative you'll become, and the more potential you'll see in every situation. This is the black belt perspective. This is what you're training for.